Countdown is sponsored by I Believe Gel. Pain relief you can count on.
Welcome to Countdown. Now, did you know that 101 years ago today, SOS became the standard radio distress symbol for ships at sea? SOS, the acronym, of course, for Save Our Souls. It was a clear and easy message to send in Morse code, three dots, three dashes, three more dots, absolutely simple. And it's got me thinking, what other acronyms do we now use all the time? Well, there's RSVP, AKA, BLT, BYO, TLC, PVC, ESP, and Bog Off. Buy one, get one free. But the one I can relate to, and I'm sure it's going to catch on, is kippers. Kids in parents' pockets eroding retirement savings. And my lord, not even teenagers just yet. Time to say hello to Orange. Our Rachel, a number grafter extraordinaire. Hi, Rachel.
Oh, you call me Oompa Loompa. I think we should call you Salmon as well, in honour of your shirt. Suave and likeable, minuscule old northerner.
That was half good. The first half. Let's meet our contestants today, our returning champion. Innes Carson is from Bearsden in East Dumbartonshire. He's topped a century in every single appearance so far. And you're currently on a long summer break before going off to Edinburgh University to study chemistry. Yep. In Innes' spare time, he enjoys playing the trumpet, and he also enjoys playing Countdown online. So is that how you got to be so good?
Entirely, yeah. That's just... yes.
We'll take that as a yes. Yeah. Been pretty impressive so far, to say the least. Up against Innes is Alan Barnes. Alan is from Greetham, which is on the outskirts of the pearl of the Northeast Riviera, Hartlepool. He worked in IT for 35 years before retiring. He lives with his partner, Val, has a grandson in the USA and a granddaughter in New Zealand. He's a keen gardener and allotment holder, and his ambition is to visit the Galapagos Islands to see the giant turtles and other creatures. Importantly, Alan is a Hartlepool United season ticket holder, so he and I are going to get on very well indeed. And it's a nice thought, isn't it, Alan? We'll be playing the likes of Southampton next season.
We will, won't we? Yes.
Three easy points for us, is the way I see it.
Yes, they hardly need to turn up, do they?
Yeah. We had quite a restful second half of the season. We didn't turn up at all, did we?
No.
Never mind.
We managed to survive, just.
We survived, just, absolutely. Our champion, then, is Innes Carson, and the challenger today, Alan Barnes. And joining Susie Dent over in Dictionary Corner today, it's a fellow who is fond of his visits to KFC, Matt Letizia.
Thank you very much, Mr. Spelling.
Or should we call you MLT?
MLT, yeah.
MLT, that
absolutely
works well, doesn't it?
Yeah, why not?
I tell you, Susie, OK is probably the most frequently used acronym, but I've got to be honest, I don't know what it stands for. Any idea?
That's very old. It's almost 200 years old. And you know how we use text abbreviations? You mentioned some of them now, LOL and that kind of thing. Well, believe it or not, back in the 19th century, they did the same thing. And OK was short for all correct, deliberately misspelled. So it's ORLKORRECT, I think. And it stuck because it was taken on board by a presidential candidate whose nickname was Old Kinderhook, and he was called the OK candidate. And from then on, it just went bigger and bigger.
Okay.
Okay.
Time to start. Here's round one. It's a letters round. Innes, of course, is our defending champion. And as such, he has first pick of those letters. Innes.
Hi again, Rachel.
Hi again, Innes.
Can I start with our consonant, please?
Thank you. Start with B.
Another one.
G.
Another one.
L.
A vowel.
A.
And again.
E.
One more.
Another A.
Consonant.
L.
Another one.
S.
And another one.
And a final N.
And for the first time today, it's time to start the countdown clock. So, Alan, what have you started with?
Six.
Six. And Innes?
Seven.
OK. Alan, what's your six?
Gables.
Gables. And Innes?
Lasagna.
Very good.
Very good.
Excellent. That's there for seven.
Well very good done. Indeed. Matt, Susie, what have you got?
There was another seven there as well, Jeff. The Bangles.
Right, Bangles, yeah, very good. Innes has seven. Alan yet to get off the mark. He can put that right in this, the second round, because it's his pick of the letters.
Hello, Rachel. Can
Hi,
I start
Alan.
With a vowel, please?
You can, thank you. O.
And another.
E.
And another.
A.
And a consonant.
T.
And another.
D.
And another.
R.
And another.
Another T.
And a vowel, please.
I.
And another consonant.
And a final S.
And your 30 seconds starts now. How many?
Risky nine.
Risky nine. OK. Alan?
Just six.
OK. Let's hear the six then, Alan.
Stored.
Stored. Yeah. And the risky nine?
Storiated.
Oh, that's superb. It's so good. We didn't have it, I have to say. We'll look at it. I know it is in, for sure. It is. It's decorated with historical, legendary or emblematic designs. It's rare, but it's in.
Astonishing. Anything come close to that?
There was a couple of eights which came close, but obviously not as good. We had Asteroid.
Yes.
And Toastier.
Toastier, yeah. Countdown favourite. On to our next round then. It's another letters round, and this time, Innes, it's your pick.
Start with a consonant, please.
Thank you, Innes. P.
Another one.
S.
And a vowel.
A.
Another one.
I.
A consonant.
F.
Another one.
M.
A vowel.
A.
Consonant.
Y.
And another consonant.
And to finish, M.
And time starts now. Alan, how many this time?
Just four.
And Innes?
Six.
OK, Alan, what's yours?
Yams.
And Innes?
Mafias.
Mafias.
Mafias, yep. I think it's certainly there with a small M, so you can certainly have it as a generic noun, and that means I'm pretty sure that you can pluralise it. You can. Any organised group of criminals resembling the mafia in its way of operating. Well done.
Very good.
Yep, very good indeed. Matt, Susie, what have you got?
I'm afraid he beat us again, didn't
he? Yes, we just have Mames for five.
Brilliant start from Innes at the moment. He's on 31 in these very early stages. Alan's yet to score, but there's a long, long way to go. That can change very quickly. Here's our next letters round. And, Alan, it's your pick.
Have a consonant, please.
Thank you, Alan. S.
And another.
M.
And another.
N.
And another.
V.
And a vowel.
O.
And another.
E.
And another.
A.
And a consonant.
R.
And a consonant.
And to finish, G.
And here's the countdown clock. Thank you. Innes, how many this time?
Seven.
And Alan?
Eight.
OK. What's the seven, Innes?
Oranges.
Oranges, yeah. And the eight, please, Alan?
Overmans.
Overmans.
Yep. I'm sure that's fine. To overstaff is to overman. No problem with that, yes.
Very good. Any eights over there?
There was plenty of words in there. We had there was orgasm, there was moaners, but we did eventually come up with a nine, and that was mangroves.
Mangroves, very good.
Yes, mangroves are trees or shrubs which grow in tropical swampy places.
Yeah, as in mangrove swamps, yeah, very much. Innes is 31 then. Alan's in the game now. He has eight. Time for a little change because this is our first numbers round of the contest. And Innes, it's your selection.
Can I have two large numbers, please?
Two large and four small. Thank you, Innes. So we'll start the day with 10, 9, 1, 7, and the large one's 25 and 75. And the target, 411.
And 30 seconds to reach that target. Alan?
411.
411. Innes?
I've got 411, but I'll run down.
OK, well, let's hear your version then, please, Innes.
75 minus 25 is 50.
75 minus 25 is 50.
Take away 9 is 41.
Minus 9 is 41.
Times 10.
Times 10 is 410.
And add 1.
And add the 1. Very nice.
Very good. Alan, was it the same way?
No, different. 25 plus 9 plus 7 25. Is 41.
Plus 9 plus 7 is 41.
And then times 10.
Times 10 for 410 again. Yep, very nice.
Very good. Innes has 41. Alan has 18 then at the moment. And they can just take a little breather because we're off to Dictionary Corner. Matt, what are we going to talk about today?
I want to talk about the things that kids can say at the most opportune moments, Jeff. And it was actually my daughter, Keely. It was only six at the time. I had my testimonial matches, my last ever game of my career. And we've got a load of ex-England players down to play against the Southampton team. So the likes of Gazza and Peter Beardsley, Stuart Pearce, Alan Shearer, those kind of players all came down and played in my testimonial match. And it was a wonderful evening. My son, who was 10, Mitchell, he came on the last few minutes and they let him score a few goals, and he actually scored one, which I don't think the goalkeeper let him score. But it was really great. It was a really emotional evening for me. It was a full house at St Mary's. And at the end of the game, unbeknown to me, my testimonial committee had put up on the screen a two-minute video montage of all my best goals of my career. And it would be fair to say at this point in my career, I probably wasn't the same weight that I was when I started. And we were watching the big screens at St Mary's showing a clips of my best goals. And I had my six-year-old daughter in my arms. It was lovely. She'd never really seen me play because she was so young. And she was glued to the screen watching these goals. And I felt really proud that finally, you know, she could see what her dad used to be able to do. And she's watching away, and all these England players are there and all staring at the screens at St Mary's. And I was filling up, and I was just about to break down into tears because it was a really emotional evening. And my daughter looked back from the screens and she turned to me and she said, "Daddy, you were quite good when you were little."
I know I've told this before, but because you're here, Matt, I remember my son, Robbie, when he was, what, seven, going around St Mary's and being shown around by Rupert Lowe, who was the then chairman. And Rupert showed Robbie the trophy cabinet, and Robbie said, "Not much of a trophy cabinet, is it?"
Great,
which was accurate. Absolutely, absolutely accurate. Innes has 41 at the moment, and Alan has 18 then. We're going to take a short break. Here's your first teaser. The words are winds bore. And the clue, up above the streets and houses, they fly high. Up above the streets and houses, they fly high.
I Believe Gel for joint and muscular pain sponsors Countdown. I Believe Gel for joint and muscular pain. Sponsors Countdown.
Up above the streets and houses, they fly high rainbows. The answer to our teaser. Innes has 41. He is flying high at the moment. Alan's chasing hard on 18. Here's our next round, and Alan, it's your pick of the letters.
Can I have a consonant, please?
Thank you. Alan, T.
And another.
H.
And another.
N.
And another.
T.
And a vowel.
I.
Another.
E.
And another.
O.
And another.
Another O.
And a consonant, please.
And a final W.
And here's the countdown clock. Innes, how many this time?
Six.
Six, and Alan?
Just five.
Just five. What's the five, Alan?
Twine.
Twine, and Innes?
Tony.
Yes, it's absolutely fine. It's about IE. You can also spell it with a double E, but that's very good indeed.
Sixers, Matt, Susie, anything better?
We had Whiten, and something that obviously the two girls in this studio could be described as. Hottie.
Innes has 47. Alan has 18 then. On to our next letters round. Innes, your pick.
Start with that consonant, please.
Thank you. Start with X.
Another one, I think.
L.
And again.
G.
A vowel.
A.
Another one.
E.
A consonant.
R.
And again.
T.
Vowel.
A.
And a consonant.
And a final N.
And your 30 seconds starts now. Alan?
I'll risk a seven.
OK. And Innes?
I'll stick with six.
OK, what's yours then, Innes?
Tangle.
Tangle. Alan?
I put an R on it, Tangler.
Tangler.
Matt just did exactly the same and asked me if you could have it, so I did check, but you can't, I'm afraid. Sorry, Alan. Mm. Can't be a Tangler.
What else could we have had?
We did have another six, which is Lager, which you might think has only got five. But Susie's going to explain.
Yeah, you can spell it with a double A, and in South Africa, a long time ago, it was an encampment formed by a circle of wagons. It's a verb as well. That's letter six.
Innes, flying along at the moment, he has 53. Alan has 18. Here's the next letters round. Alan, it's your choice.
Can I have a consonant, please?
Thank you, Alan. C.
And another.
R.
And another.
B.
And another.
H.
And a vowel.
O.
And another.
I.
And another.
E.
And a consonant, please.
S.
And another, please.
And finally, P.
Time starts now. I'm Innes.
Seven.
Seven. And Alan?
Seven.
Seven. What's yours, Alan?
Copiers.
Copiers. Innes?
Porches.
Yeah, very good.
Yes.
Matt, Susie?
There were quite a few sevens there, actually. We had a hospice and birches as well. And there was an eight in there. Brioches.
Okay, very good. Innes, 60. Alan, 25. It's Innes's pick of the letters this time round.
Start with a vowel, please.
Thank you. Start with O.
Consonant.
T.
Another one.
M.
And a vowel.
I.
Another vowel.
A.
Consonant.
R.
Another one.
C.
A vowel.
U.
And a consonant.
And lastly, D.
And your time starts now. Alan, how many this time?
Just five.
Just five. Innes?
Seven.
OK, what's the five, Alan?
Triad.
And the seven, please, Innes?
Auditor.
An auditor is brilliant.
Very good.
Yeah, absolutely. Very good indeed.
Can you match that?
We could match it with carotid.
All right, very good.
Yes, carotid is one of the two main arteries which carry blood to the head and neck.
OK. Innes has 67 at the moment. Alan has 25. They can both relax just for a second or two. We'll have to delve into the origins of some more words with Susie. Susie, what do you got for us today?
Yes, yeah, slightly different linguistic story, because it's mostly a story about how a certain thing in football came about, but there is a linguistic edge to it. And it's the red card. You know, where does the idea of the red card, the yellow card, come from in football? And so obviously the red-coloured card shown to, by the referee to a player to send him off, and Matt had only two, I think I'm right in saying. And the concept came about because the chairman of FIFA, Kenneth George Aston, in 1966, he got a call from the 1966 World Cup tournament manager, and he was querying whether Bobby and Jack Charlton had been cautioned by the referee in the match the previous day. And the reason they didn't know is that the referee spoke only German, so they weren't quite sure what the referee had said to them. And so he tried to clear this up. I'm not actually sure whether they had got one or not. But as he was driving home, Kenneth George Aston was driving along thinking, this is ridiculous. Why is there such a language barrier? You know, why do these kind of controversies or confusions come about? And as he was driving, he went through a series of green traffic lights and had to stop at a set of red traffic lights. And that's apparently how it came into his head that red cards would be like red lights, and that's what he would show, that, well, not he, but the referee should show the players. So he'd overcome the language barrier that way.
Fantastic.
I have to say, I'm indebted to Bob Wilson for that story, because he's done some wonderful detective work on sporting lingo.
Yeah, it's a brilliant story. Ken Aston, I think, was a former referee, wasn't he?
Yes, he was.
One stage, yeah. Innes has 67, Alan has 25. Here's our next round. This is a numbers round. And, Alan, it's your selection.
Can I have six small numbers, please?
Oh, six small. One, two, three, four, five, and six. Thank you, Alan. This round we have 2, 5, 3... Another 3, 6, and 9. And the target, 658.
And 30 seconds to reach that target.
No, I didn't see anything.
Nothing on?
Nowhere near anymore.
Nowhere near?
No.
OK. So it's not quite an open goal, but the field is yours and yours alone, Rachel. 6, 5, 8.
I got something. I didn't get 6, 5, 8.
Well, I got something. I got 4-2-1, but, you know.
I'll carry on. I got within 10, but I'll carry on and get closer.
OK. It was very difficult indeed. Innes has 67. Alan has 25. Here's a teaser for you. The words are red mares, and the clue, do they lie in bed thinking of Freddy? Do they lie in bed thinking of Freddy?
I Believe Gel for joint and muscular pain. Sponsors Countdown.
Hello, good evening.
Channel 4. Home for challenging and groundbreaking entertainment. But with the arrival of digital switchover, television as you know it is changing. This is not goodbye.
This is hello.
Hello.
Hello, pilgrims.
Hey, Lee Ho, neighbour.
Hello to more choice with our award-winning digital channels. Hello to more services. HD, Channel 4 Plus 1, and on demand.
What do you think of that, then?
Yeah! Get set for digital. Say hello today.
Hello?
To find out how you can get set for digital, go to channel4.com/digitalTV.
I Believe Gel for joint and muscular pain. Sponsors Countdown.
Do they lie in bed thinking of Freddy? The answer is dreamers. You have to have a certain age to understand that. The Freddy in question was Freddy Garrity of the group Freddy and the Dreamers from the 1960s. Innes has 67 and Alan has 25. Here's our next letters round. Innes, your pick.
I'll start with a consonant, please.
Thank you, Innes. T.
Another one, please.
D.
And a vowel.
I.
Consonant again.
T.
Vowel.
E.
Consonant.
R.
Vowel.
U.
Consonant.
D.
And vowel.
And a final I.
And your 30 seconds starts now. Alan, how many this time?
Six.
Six. And Innes?
Six.
Yeah, what's yours, Innes?
Tidier.
Uh-huh. And yours, Alan?
Rutted.
Rutted, yeah. Yeah, a couple of sixes. Anything more than six, Matt, Susie?
Yeah, there was a seven in there. Dirtied.
Dirtied. Yeah, very good indeed.
It's a bit dirty. That was it.
OK. But Innes and Alan both came up with sixes. It means that Innes has 73, Alan has 31. Here's our next letters round. Alan, it's your pick this time.
Have a consonant, please.
Thank you, Alan. S.
And another.
T.
And another.
Q.
And another.
P.
And a vowel.
E.
And another.
A.
And another.
O.
And a consonant.
S.
And a consonant.
And a final F.
Time starts now. Innes, what have you found?
Six again.
Six. And Alan?
Six.
Yeah. What's yours, Alan?
Pastes.
Pastes. And Innes?
Spate.
Yeah.
Spate, yes.
Lots of sixes.
There was one seven, and we've had a couple of hotties, and now we've got a couple of fatsos. Before you asked, that was me and you, Jeff.
Yeah. I always thought fatsos was just F-A-T-S-O-S.
S-O-S, yeah. It can be O-E-S as well.
OK.
Yeah.
Innes has 79, Alan has 37 at the moment. Here's the next letters round, and Innes, it's your go.
Start with a consonant, please.
Thank you. Start with P.
And another one.
S.
And again.
Z.
Vowel.
A.
Another one.
E.
Consonant.
N.
A vowel.
A.
Consonant.
D.
And a vowel.
And a final O.
And here's the countdown clock. Alan, how many this time?
Six.
And Innes?
Six.
OK, what's yours, Innes?
Pandas.
And yours, Alan?
Anodes.
Anodes. Pandas and anodes.
Sure, that's fine. I've just forgotten the definition of anode, which I can tell you.
The cathode.
Positively charged electrodes.
OK, what else have we got over there?
No, that was... we had pandas as well. That was as good as we could do.
OK. Innes has 85. Alan has 43. At the moment. Time for our next round. It's the final numbers round of this contest. And Alan, it's your pick this time.
I'll have six small ones
six
again.
Six small again.
And hope for something easier.
Yes, I think that would be nice for this final game. Couldn't be much worse than the last one. Anyway, we've got one, two, ten. We like ten. Another two, four, and five. And the target, 472.
30 seconds to reach that target. Let's see how we've done this time. Innes?
Yeah, I might be able to wing 470, but nothing written down.
OK. Alan?
I've lost it.
OK. Well, Innes, let's hear your version.
Five times two is 10.
Five times two is 10.
Plus the two is
plus
12.
Plus the two is 12.
Times four is 48.
Times four is 48.
Yeah. Minus 1 and times 10.
Minus 1 is 47 and times 10 for 470.
470 then. Can we get closer?
We can, hopefully. If you say 10 plus 2 is 12, times by 5 is 60. 60 minus 1 is 59. Times by 2 is 118. And times that by 4 for 472.
Brilliant. Innes has 92, Alan has 43, and it's come to that stage of the contest, chaps, when we ask you to put your fingers on the buzzers as we reveal today's countdown conundrum.
Deflected.
Let's take a look. This is absolutely true. I had not taken my finger off the button that starts the clock when he buzzed. Absolutely sensational. And it means, again, five successive centuries now for Innes. He's finished on 102. Alan has finished on 43. So commiserations, Alan. It was a brief stay. The Galapagos Islands, your ambition then, is that likely to come about soon?
I think it might one day. I mean, we've actually just been to New Zealand to see my daughter and granddaughter out there, so it's sort of halfway, perhaps.
And 43 points, well, that's almost as many as Hartlepool got this season, so that's not bad.
Not bad.
Yeah, just a few short, yeah.
Just could have gone down with that many points.
Well, very well played indeed. And Innes, look, I know you said before you didn't have your eyes on being an octo champ, but five straight wins.
Yeah,
beginning to get in the mind a bit?
A bit.
Well, you look untouchable at the moment, absolutely untouchable. So well played, we'll see you again tomorrow. Matt, you mentioned going down, and it must have broken your heart that last season your beloved Southampton went down.
Yeah, it did indeed. Sad, really. Then you think of just a few short years ago, we were mixing it with the big boys and in the FA Cup final. And now we're going to places like Victoria Park, sadly.
Nothing wrong with Victoria Park. And it's terrible because some cruel people, you know, they take advantage of other people's misfortunes by telling gags like which three ships have left Southampton never to return. The Titanic, the Premiership and the Championship. Is the answer.
We'll be back. We'll be back.
We'll see you at Victoria Park next season. We'll see you tomorrow. Likewise, Susie. Also, Rachel. See you all. Hope you'll join us again 3:25 tomorrow. Bye-bye now.
Countdown is sponsored by I Believe Gel, pain relief you can count on.